All protein synthesis in eukaryotes begins in the cytosol, where ribosomal subunits come together and begin translating an mRNA near its 5' end. Soon after the protein starts to emerge from the ribosome, it may become directed to the endoplasmic reticulum, or ER. It is targeted to the ER if it is ultimately destined for incorporation into the ER, the Golgi apparatus, lysosomes, or plasma membrane, or if it is destined for secretion. In mammalian cells, most proteins enter the ER cotranslationally. These proteins have an amino acid sequence called a signal sequence, which is typically located at the amino terminus of the polypeptide chain. Signal sequences span about 20 amino acids and include a stretch of hydrophobic amino acids preceded by a basic amino acid. As a signal sequence emerges from the ribosome, it is recognized and bound by a signal recognition particle, or SRP, consisting of 6 polypeptides and a small cytoplasmic RNA. The SRP binds the ribosome as well as the signal sequence, and in so doing, stalls translation. The SRP targets the entire complex to the rough endoplasmic reticulum by binding to an SRP receptor on the membrane of the ER. GTP molecules bind to the SRP and the SRP receptor. The GTP binding triggers the transfer of the signal sequence from the SRP to a membrane channel called a translocon. Hydrolysis of GTP to GDP leads to the dissociation of SRP from both the receptor and the ribosome mRNA complex. Transfer of the ribosome mRNA complex to the translocon allows the signal sequence to interact with short hydrophobic side chains located in the narrow neck of the translocon channel. This interaction opens the translocon by moving the plug away from the translocon channel. As translocation proceeds, the signal sequence is cleaved by signal peptidase, and the polypeptide is released into the lumen of the ER. Thus, the process of protein synthesis directly drives the transfer of growing polypeptide chains through the translocon and into the ER.